This will be kind of interesting because this is a Les Paul tribute. I guess it's made somewhere else. And it's basically new, right out of the store. They gave him the polka chip, but they didn't install it. That can not always be the easiest thing to do without making a big mess. What else? Well, let's just mount up and see what we can find. So it came with this cool little photograph. I guess that's the guitar on the bench being looked at. And a bunch of check marks of things they check. Playability, action, intonation, buzzing, electronics. The peg head and nut. Yes, it has one. Fretboard. See, they checked it off. This is where it falls apart. Because on the treble side, there's all kinds of sharp fret ends. Bass side is all good. So it's like, it almost feels like they did half the guitar and then didn't do this half. So that was a fail. Also, the other thing that we're noticing too is that the stop bar is cranked down so low that the strings are actually touching the bridge, and we know we can't have that. We can't have that. It's just not acceptable. So, let's just see what the neck straightness is all about. So like I said, I haven't touched anything. And the person that brought it to me doesn't trust the store, and I don't blame him either. So let's just see. Well, neck straightness is good. I wouldn't screw around with that. And what did they give him for string height? Excuse me. They gave him... Yeah, that's well within reason. So, but I'm thinking, I'm looking, pickup height doesn't look right here either. That's too close. I can tell by just looking at it. So, I guess the first thing to do is we're going to get the strings off and correct the sharp fret ends. The tip du jour. So, I always clip these about that long, and I save those. Because you may have seen before when you have a hex screw that's all packed with crud, those are your cleaners. So then what I do is somewhere I have a rare earth magnet over here. Boop. I just stick them on a magnet. Keep a bundle of those for another day when there's another problem. My favorite sharp fret end file. I'm not sure if it's going to do what I want it to do. Seems like it. Sure. Okay, in other news, I got a notification from the YouTube. Boy, they have really swept through that whole organization, man. So, you know, you remember all that sort of jackass sort of stuff, you know, pranking people and that sort of stuff, right? A lot of those guys lost all their channels. And what's coming up, I'm told, and if they say it, it will happen. All the interactive comments are going to vanish. So what will happen is you'll be able to comment on a video, but you will be literally screaming at the television because no one can interact with your comment. And they're going to push it all over to social media. Other social medias. So YouTube is becoming more and more and more like television, and less like the interactive thing that it started as. I don't know. Do you guys remember, I don't know, it depends how long you've been playing on the YouTube, you remember when you used to be able to have a response video? So if somebody made a video, you could actually make a video in response? They can that quite a while ago. That's feeling a lot better. Yeah, it's really like they almost didn't finish this side of the guitar. Let me try and get that guy. Sure. Yeah, so I don't know if they, I think they said that the end of August, that interactive comments will be no more. And another big thing about copyright strikes, right? Because that turned into a big mess. Because the way they set it up is that even if you didn't have a copyright on the material, you could make a copyright claim. And I was reading one thing, what the dude did, what some dude, hacker dude did, is he laid claim to copyright on a whole bunch of stuff that people had published on YouTube, and basically held their channel for ransom, and said that he'd release the copyright claims if they paid him money. How nice, right? Still something going on here with that one. Might have to get a little different file for a couple of these. This seems pretty good. Still a little bit. That guy right there, and that's a different file. So I got these two. Now this is the one that I really, 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 really like for doing what I'm gonna do. Now this is the one Bernie came up with at Fret Guru. It's nice, but it's still not quite as tiny as this one, right? So, and the thing about this one is it's pretty much exactly the width of a fret. So if I wanna get this tang, where's the one that I hated? Right there. What I can do is I can get right on that without grabbing into the fingerboard. And then the other thing, this one does this guy, if you got sharp spots in there. I think I'm pretty much out of that. What's next? I don't know. What kind of wood does that look like? The fingerboard. It's sort of a rosewoody color, but it doesn't really look like rosewood. Maybe it is. Do not know. And I know why they didn't set this where it should go, because this is froze. So I'm going to have to deal with that. I hope it's not like froze, like it doesn't move. All right, Dave's old trick here. Put the rag in there. It's just stiff. There it moves, okay. Rock and roll! Hoochie-go! Okay, we're gonna put the little poker chip on it first before we put strings on it and set it up. Your ability to mess this up is directly proportional to not having the right tool. But once in all, as always, we need to support the switch from the back when we're trying to tighten it from the front once I loosen it up. So my first choice for this job is actually the right wrench to do it with. Right? So this guy slides over top, now I can tighten that down and loosen that off and not make any marks on the guitar. Second choice, if you don't have this or want to blow the dough on it, right? This was a gift. I probably never would have bought this. This used to be my first choice, now it's my second choice, is this guy. But, I mean, it's got super smooth side on that side, right? And all those little tapered teethies. And, but even then, it's just really doesn't grab that as well as that other one does. So, let's see if we make this actually work. That seems pretty good, possibly. There we go. You can do it, Davey. She's loose. Oh, we also got that to come off at the same time. Where's that little poker chip? I don't know why. Why would they just give it to you and not put it on? I don't. Maybe because it doesn't work. Because the. And I'm guessing that's why. Because it don't work. Because there's no threads to catch now that I've got that on there. Let's see, can we do it? Come on, really? Okay, freaking hell. All right, let's get the wrench on it and get out of that. What do we got for strings? Works for me. And I gotta put the cover back on, we'll get there. All right, let's put strings on it and make it go. Little preemptive strike raising up the stop bar. It was really the two E strings that were the ones that were actually touching the back. So that's all you need. Just as long as a piece of paper goes under there, we're good to go. Okay, a little bit of string stretching. This is my technique for string stretching. Always remember, the plain strings, they won't stretch too much. That's a solid piece of wire. So, yanking on those too much, you'll just bust it. Retune it, and then we'll begin. One thing I didn't look at before I took the old strings off, I just want to check the old neck straightness again before I carry on, but it seemed pretty good. Yeah, that's wonderful. Nothing to worry about there. First fret action, which feels okay. That's usually how, like, I can usually tell right away when I pick up a guitar or a bass if you're working too hard way down here. This doesn't seem to be the case. Yeah, we're fine. It's 20 thou. They've got set, which is sort of in the middle. 22 is acceptable. 18, you're broaching a little bit on the low side. You might end up with some open string buzz. I mean, it doesn't sound or feel too bad. What did I notice before, too? The pickup height was really looking not like it should be. That's too close. That's too close. That's probably just about right. And just about right. So they've set it a little too close on the bass side. They need to be different to compensate for the different diameters in the strings. So that's still a little bit more. Rock and roll all night and party every day. Had a fantastic time with my buddies, the Killer Dwarfs, at the golf tournament. Put up the video, and Izzy Presley was there, Nikki Black. A whole bunch of other crazy yahoos. It was quite a good time. I haven't heard how much money they actually made for the charity. But we'll find out. It was all good. Gibson, we sweat the details. No, Dave sweat the details. You guys sent it away, I've done. Well, that's sort of it for this one, folks, except for clipping off the strings and giving it back to the guy that wants it back. Thanks, everybody, for hanging out. Hope everybody's had a good summer. It is coming to an end very quickly. Already had to put my hoodie on yesterday. You're joking. So with that being said, all the links to all the stuff are below. I did relaunch the Facebook group. I don't know what happened, why Facebook nuked it. It was up to about 8,500 people, and I'm still missing about 6,000 of them. So, not quite sure what to say. You can get a Dave's World of Fun Stuff sticker, Penny Black CD. You can become a patron. Special shout out to my patrons, as always, and the Facebook group and subscribers and everybody, but most of all, be good to each other. Cheers. Till next time, folks.